The commonplace routine of a typical Monday morning would never be the same again. For into this quiet little community came Mr. Neutron. Mr. Neutron, the most dangerous and terrifying man in the world. The man with the strength of an army, the wisdom of all the scholars in history. The man who had the power to destroy the world. Mr. Neutron. No one knows what strange and distant planet he came from or where he was going to. Wherever he went, terror and destruction were sure to follow. Mr. Neutron, the man whose incredible power has made him the most feared man of all time, waits for his moment to destroy this little world utterly.
Then there's Stanley. He's our eldest. He's a biochemist in Sutton. He's married to Shirley.
Shirley, who used to be the hairdresser.
Yes, that's right. I think she's a lovely person. Mind you, my husband doesn't think she's a bit, flash.
I hate her. I hate her guts.
Of course, they come down most weekends, so you'll be able to meet them then.
I'd love to. Hairdressing is very interesting.
Oh, yes, and very important too. If you don't care for your scalp, you get rabies. Then there's Kenneth, he's our youngest. Mind you, he's a bit of a problem, at least my husband thinks he is anyway.
Nasty little piece of work he is. I hate him.
Mind you, the one we don't hear much about nowadays is Karen. She married a Canadian. He's a dentist. They live in Alberta. Two lovely children. Gary, who's 3. Leslie, who's 6. Leslie looks absolutely spitting image of Karen. Do you want to see a photo?
Oh, yes, please.
All right.
They're a couple of little bastards. They've got eyes like little pigs, just like their mother. She's a disaster. Really horrible-looking person she is. I thought that one would stay on the shelf. Along comes this stupid dentist git. He's a real creepy little bastard, he is, I hate him.
This is a nice area.
It's like a bloody graveyard, I hate it.
It's handy for the shops and convenient for the West End.
If you like going to the West End, I think it's a stinking dump.
Meanwhile, in Washington, at the headquarters of FEAR, the Federal Egg Answering Room, in reality a front name for Feeble, the Free World Extra-Earthly Body's Location and Extermination Center, all was not well.
Good God! Get me the Supreme Commander of Lancian Air Forces! Immediately!
You mean Feeble?
Yes, sir.
What is it?
Mr. Neutron is missing, sir.
Mr. Neutron? Oh, my God! Okay, surround the entire city. Send in 4 waves of armed paratroopers with full ground-to-air missile support. Alert all air bases. Destroy all roads. We'll bomb the town flat if we have to.
Sir, he's not in Washington, sir.
Okay, hold everything. Hold it. Lay off. Where is he?
We don't know, sir. All we know is he checked out of his hotel and took a bus to the airport.
All right. I want a full-scale red alert throughout the world. Surround everyone with everything we got. Mobilize every fighting unit and every weapon we can lay our hands on. I want 3 full-scale global nuclear alerts with every Army, Navy, and Air Force unit on eternal standby.
Right, sir.
And introduce conscription!
Yes, sir!
Right!
So the world was in the grip of fear. A huge and terrifying crisis generated by one man. Easily the most dangerous man the world has ever seen. Honestly! Though still biding his time, he could strike at any moment. Could he be stopped in time?
Got a bit of work to do there, then.
Yes, it is a problem.
Mrs. Ottershaw never used to bother. Then, of course, she was very old. She was 206. I must be going. If you need a hand, I'll send Frank round. He could do with a bit of exercise. That old bastard.
Ha ha!
We've been on red alert now for 3 days, sir. Still no sign of Mr. Neutron.
Have we bombed anywhere? Have we shown him we got teeth?
Oh, yes, sir. We bombed a lot of places flat, sir.
Good, good. We don't want anyone to think we're chicken.
Oh, no, they don't think that, sir. Everyone's really scared of us, sir.
Of us?
Yes, sir.
Of our power?
Oh, yes, sir. They're really scared when they see those big planes come over.
Wow, I bet they are. I bet they are. I bet they're really scared.
Oh, they are, sir.
Do we have any figures on how scared they are?
No figures, sir. But they sure were scared.
Ah. But it's not working.
No, sir.
Okay. We'll try another tactic. We'll try and outsmart this Neutron guy. Yeah, there's one man I know who could nail him.
One guy? That won't frighten anyone, sir.
He's the most brilliant man I ever met. We were in the CIA together. He's retired now. He breeds rabbits up in the Yukon.
What's his name, sir?
His name is Teddy Salad.
Salad, as in?
Lettuces, cucumber, radishes, yeah.
Where do I find him, sir?
The Yukon. Oh, and Carpenter.
Yes, sir?
Make sure you get a decent disguise.
Carpenter, I'm from the U.S. government.
Are you from the Army?
No. I'm from the Ballet, the U.S. government Ballet.
The Ballet? The Ballet's coming here?
Well, maybe.
Oh, that's great. We love the Ballet. Last year, some of us from Yellow River, we got on a party to go and see the Ballet in Montreal.
Look, I was wondering
if... Oh, we had a marvelous time. It was Margot Fontaine dancing Les Sylphides. Oh, it was beautiful.
Look, do you know...
Do you know how old she is?
Who?
Margot Fontaine.
No.
She's 206.
Oh. Well, look, I hear there's a U.S. ballet organizer around these parts by the name of Teddy Salad.
You mean the special agent?
Well,
he's an ex-CIA man. He's not a ballet dancer.
Well, I just want to see him on some ballet business.
Oh, well, you could try the store.
Oh, thank you.
Hey, could you get us Lionel Blair's autograph?
While precious time was being lost in Canada, the seconds were ticking away for the free world. Already, Neutron, who you will remember is infinitely the most dangerous man in the world, he really is, was gathering allies together.
Try having an omelette for your evening meal, perhaps with yogurt and grapefruit.
I tried that. I once got down to 56 stone, boy. I couldn't stay like I had to take potatoes wherever I went. I used to go to the cinema with 300 weight of King Edwards. I'd eat them all before I got out of the toilet. I had to go on bread.
What about salad?
Teddy salad?
No. Salad as in lettuces, radishes, cucumber.
You don't like it?
No, I didn't want to eat a salad. I wanted to find out about a man called Salad.
You're the first person to order a salad here for 2 years. All the Eskimos eating here is fish.
We are not Eskimos. Where's our fish? We finished our fish.
What a fish you want today, huh?
Bream!
Where do I get the bream at this time of year, you bloody choosy Eskimo pests?
We are not Eskimos.
Why don't you like a nice plate of cannelloni?
That's not fish.
Oh, I've had my lot in the Arctic Circle. I wish I was back in Oldham.
Do any of you Eskimos speak English?
We are not Eskimos.
I am.
Shh!
Hello!
Where?
Do any of you know a man called Salad?
What? Salad as in?
Lettuce, cucumbers, tomatoes, yeah?
Like you have on your plate?
Yeah, that's right.
No, I'm afraid not. Where's our fish?
What does this Teddy Salad do?
Oh, he's a hen teaser.
Che cosa? L'elasticatore di porno.
No, the only Teddy Salad we know is a CIA man.
Oh, he might know.
Go, where's our fish?
Where will I find him?
Oh, he lives up at Kipper Sound.
Thanks a lot.
Fishy, 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 f
international spying too?
No. I'm with the U.S. Ballet Force. Who are you with?
MI6, but not a word to the Eskimos.
Fishy, fishy, yo!
Here's your bloody fish.
Thank you, Andrew.
I'm not an Eskimo!